1 year review of this beauty, Louis Vuitton Clapton backpack. Please guys, stay with me. Hello ladies, welcome to my channel. My name is Oksana. Thank you very much for clicking on this video. If you are a new visitor to my channel, I usually do review of luxury items, handbags, shoes, accessories, etc. If you are a return subscriber to my channel, thank you so very much for continue supporting me. In today's video, as I said from my introduction, I'm gonna do review of my Clapton backpack. I have this bag for about a year and I do use it enough, but not excessively. Let's say I don't use this bag every single day, because I had a discussion with one of the YouTuber and she had really bad experience with this bag. But my experience so far, thanks God, really good with this bag. I have absolutely no complaints. By default, as you know, this bag comes with two straps that you can use it as a backpack. And that's what I usually use during the summer months. Sometimes, to be honest, I don't really use it quite often as a backpack. I prefer to use it as a crossbody. But in the summertime, I do use as a backpack, or I use it as a crossbody with the use of this one strap. So it's kind of light color. In the winter months, I prefer to use this bag with the dummy airbean strap, and this is from my Speedy 25, because it's a dummy airbean, so it's a perfect match and it's a little bit thicker, so it's better when it's with the coat, etc. And obviously when it's a winter months, you can get it can get a little bit dirty outside, so the anything darker definitely better. Occasionally also I put one of those kind of like Chanel inspired chains, and this chain is actually from my Coach clutch. I have Coach clutch, which is like many years ago I purchased. It's almost sentimental value, and it's in the brown leather. So, and that's how it looks like. Sometime if I want to be looking a little bit more Chanel inspired, so I'm putting this little chain, and it's a perfect for the shoulders, like such. So perfect fit for summer. But once again, it's more on the summer months when I want to get like really fancy looking. I did my modeling shot previously, so, and I'm gonna insert those modeling shots while like if you're interested, just to see how this bag looks like on me. Lately also I tried to put my Pochette Matisse reverse monogram strap, and believe it or not, because I thought like mixing prints, like, you know, dummy a bean and monogram is not great, but actually in this case you can see it's actually quite nice. And sometimes I put also some twillies with the reverse monogram, and it's actually looking really good. So lots of options in this backpack. I mean, just if you want to make it fun, if you want to put some kind of personal touch, lots of options over there. When it comes to actual wear and tear of this bag, my personal experience, once it got dirty right there. I don't know what was the source of the dirt, but it's got dirty. And I took just a warm, I took just a cotton with a warm water, like, you know, soaked in warm water, and just kind of wiped it, and it's all gone. I'm gonna come closer to the camera. There is no trace of any dirt. That's how the bag looks like inside. And on the side, it's kind of like almost like a snap buttons. They're absolutely perfect. It's very easy to open and close. I absolutely adore also this closure. It's almost like a trunk inspired, and it's very easy to open and close. Even you can see the bag is right now empty. It's still very easy to open and close, because mostly what I have problem with all of my Louis Vuitton bags, if there is any some kind of like closure, like I don't know, C-lock, etc., it's like really sometimes could be challenging to close it when the bag is half full or half empties. The corners, let me see, like I'm gonna come closer to the camera that you can see the corners. They're in pretty good shape, I could say, so no problem there, for sure. So let me show you what can fit inside this bag, and I will try to, obviously, while I'm putting this stuff inside, maybe just show some kind of on the side image with little bit better visual what can fit inside. So usually on my normal days, day-to-day routine, I always have my Victorine wallet. Occasionally I put card holder or my Pushet Kerigami, the smallest pouch, because it's perfectly fitting all the credit cards, etc. So let's just start with the usual item, what I usually put. So my Victorine wallet goes in, my 6-key ring holder goes in, say my coin purse, round coin purse goes in. Let's say I will put my smallest Pushet Kerigami. I will put a chewing gum. I will put my iPhone. Let's say I put my glasses. That's what I usually put. And you can see there is a plenty of space over there with all those items. I can put also some more stuff if I want. Let's just try another combination. In this combination, I'm still putting my 6-key. I still put in my cell phone. Let's say I wanna put toiletry 15. Let's say I use a Zippy coin purse as my wallet, because it's actually quite usable as a wallet. There is a bunch of compartments, so it can be as a mini wallet. So let's say I'm using my Zippy coin as a wallet. Let me show you how it so far looks like, and you can see there is a plenty of space over there. Say I put my glasses on top. Like, I mean, there is a still bunch of space over there. If I'm gonna put my coin purse, that's how it looks like. You can see lots of space inside. Let's put another combination. So I take everything out and we're gonna use another combination, because I'm trying to use the most common items that 99% of you guys have. Say, if you wanna put mini pochette, I'm putting my mini pochette. I'm still putting my 6-key. So it could be your, maybe in your case you have Chanel or Gucci or whatever. So I'm putting 6 keys. Actually, you know what, guys, it's funny. For this demonstration, I was trying to find my key pouch, you know, from the Louis Vuitton. And I put it somewhere and I cannot find. You know, for the name of God, I cannot find. I lost key pouch in my own house. I don't know, put your comments below if it's ever happened to you, like you actually lost some of the SLGs in your own house. I don't know, that's the problem when you have a bunch of those little thingies, you don't know where you put them any longer. Closing, no problem. Lots of space to play over here. If you have Chanel or pouch, and you can use it as a catch-all or as a wallet. Many girls I know, they're using this as a wallet. You still need your key holder, some kind of key holder. As I said, in my case, it's a 6-key holder, but this could be your key pouch. I wish if I can show for you right now, but As I mentioned, I don't know, I misplaced it. I put it somewhere I cannot find. I cannot find my key pouch any longer. So we have Chanel O case. We have 6 keys. Let's say in this case, I wanna put a bigger wallet. I'm putting my Victorine wallet and it's quite full. And like if you're looking at Victorine wallet, it's pretty much equivalent to 2 SLGs. It's quite like, you know, chubby looking wallet. So I'm putting my Victorine wallet. I have to put my cell phone 100%. So I'm putting my glasses. Let's say I'm putting my coin purse. What else? Let's say I will put my little kirigami. There you go. It's actually, like, I can put even more. If I need, I can put a second pair of glasses, etc. So, as I said, it's not a big bag from outside, but it fits a lot. And the greatest point of this bag, as I said, because the side, they're magnetic, so it's very easy if you need the access when you're opening up, so it's very easy to get something in and out of the bag. But when you're closing, it just like that, and it's a perfect. And you know, I like that those pleats, they're always stay there after you close the bag. Absolutely perfect. So far, as I said, I had no issue whatsoever. And in my latest months, I really, like, I mean, I always love Damia Bean print, but lately I'm really falling in love with the Damia Bean print because it's very subtle, very classy, not like, you know, flashy, to your face, etc. Not that I don't like monogram. I have several items in monogram, but if I want to be more, like, you know, less noticeable, let's put it this way, then I'm definitely reaching for my Damia Bean print. I find it's very, very classy. It goes with almost every possible colors on the planet. So I absolutely, absolutely in love with this beautiful bag. If you have, guys, any questions or concern, please put your questions and concerns below. I will gladly answer any of your questions if you have, because I know this bag is quite popular. It's getting extremely popular, but some people are have a bunch of concerns with the quality issue. Talking about the quality issue, everybody's saying that, you know, in recent years there is a quality issues with Louis Vuitton, but what I find, it's not just with Louis Vuitton. I guess it's like with every fashion house nowadays. You know, you're buying and you never know what's gonna happen with the item. Before, when you're buying an item from the luxury fashion house, it's almost guarantee of the quality. Nowadays is not as much, unfortunately, not as much. I one thing I want to bring to your attention, I never sprayed anything on the treated leather part, and I have several questions in regards to the color transfer. Did I get ever any color transfer? No, I didn't get any color transfer. I never had any problem with the glazing. The glazing is in absolutely pristine condition, so no issue whatsoever. But I'm also mindful, let's say if I'm wearing black denim and it's a brand new pair of black denim, never washed, or like dark blue denim, never washed, would I put this bag rubbing against that dark denim? Definitely not. Definitely not. So I'm more mindful when I'm using my bags, and I'm trying to be more careful. So that's about it. So I hope, guys, that you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, once again, please do not hesitate. Please put your questions below. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up. And if you like my channel in general, please consider subscribing. I hope to see you again on my channel. And until our next meeting, bye-bye.